this motherfucker. Some bad bitch mother in this motherfucker. Amen.
Bad bitch mother.
Y'all
gonna turn.
BBB. Alright. Ladies and gentlemen, starting off the How I Lost My Virginity Hour is my brother, man, one of my close friends, actually, in comedy, super duper funny. You know y'all gonna enjoy him all the way from South Carolina, the king of the Carolinas, my dog, O.D. O'Dell.
Yep, that's about what happened, black boy. She got slayed. What up, y'all? Right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna tell y'all about the best worst thing that ever happened to me. It was this shit. I lost my virginity. First of all, I was old as hell before I got some pussy. Because when I was in ninth grade, a nigga in my ninth grade class father was a gynecologist and decided to send some slides to show us some of the shit going on with women before we out here having unprotected sex. And I saw some of this is my first real graphic pussy I ever really see up close with the lips open and shit. And I seen shit speckly and leaking shit and small disc. I was like, you know what? I don't know why motherfuckers out here killing people by this shit right here. Man, so by the time I'm 17, my nuts so big, I gotta walk around. I'm walking like a cowboy at school, people. Man, the nuts on swole. I'm not jacking off because I'm from Newark, you know what I'm saying? Niggas don't jack off, yo. Fuck out of here, jack your dick, what the fuck, yo? Niggas don't jack your dick, yo. What the fuck? So you get that bourbon to your head, nigga, you walk around with swole up nuts. Oh. And the only way I could bust a nut is if I had a wet dream. And I used to look forward to them. I used to try to go back to sleep. Like, God damn. I know my drawers gonna be stuck to me, but fuck it, nigga. That's the best showers. So, This is how I meet my baby mama. Yes, my baby mama is who I lost my virginity to, and she became my baby mama on our first time doing it.
Hell no.
Nigga, yes. That's why I call my daughter Hole in One. Hey. I'll never forget it.
That's funny.
My cousin go with her sisters, who also subsequently had kids, so now our kids' cousins two times. Real Carolina shit. Carolina shit. So.
Say it one more time.
Wait, you didn't catch it.
Look, my second cousin.
Yeah.
Had a baby and got married to her sister. I had a baby with the younger sister. So our kids are first and third cousins. But they raised up like sisters and brothers. Shit country, man. But anyway, my life going in the ancient spiral downwards and I'm failing classes and getting kicked out of school. I'm in alternative school at this moment. So now that means that I'm so unruly in school that they gotta send me to school where kids ain't at school. So I go to school at 5 o'clock, from 5 to 8. So all during the day, I'm at the crib, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, shit, this might cut, come through, boom. So she get a ride to school on the bus, like she going to school. I go scoop up, and my mama Chevrolet Corsica.
Okay.
Corsica. Yeah, and I race your motherfucking ass, too. And my mama shit, nigga, what? I ain't know what to do as a driver. I was like, that's how you race, nigga, you put the car in cruise control, and you hold that acceleration button. That's how you gas up on the bitch, nigga. What the fuck? You fucking up transmission. So anyway. Scooped up, got a whole night before, we talking all sexy in the phone. I'm popular at school, so everybody think I'm fucking. I ain't fucking shit. Nuts on swole, goddamn. So she thinking I'm fucking, I'm putting up the facade like I be beating pussy up. You know what I'm saying? Like my whole shit talking game lane when I'm telling her I'm gonna beat the pussy up. I'm like, yeah, you know, get some strawberries and some lotion and ice cream. All kind of shit that I think is supposed to make fucking somebody good because I see it on TV. Not knowing that don't mean a goddamn thing, knowing what I know now. I was so stupid. She lying, acting like like, she done fucked before. Yeah, I did it one time. You know what I'm saying? I was like, yeah, what happened? I put it on. Oh, okay, your first time? Goddamn, okay. So, we get up, I realize it's her first time. Like, she took off her clothes. My dick was hard already. My dick was hard when I woke up that day. That way, no kind of visual stimulus, my dick was on leggy. You know what I'm saying? So I pull up to the school. I'm trying to act. Like, I still don't really know how to get the pussy. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the car hitting her and she gets the fuck out of me. You know what I'm saying? We get to the house. She took off the clothes. I get everything I said we was going to get, but I don't got none of the shit I said we was going to have. Like, I was talking about the lotion. We had the lotion. We had a little Jergens. But then, you know what I'm saying? I ain't got the chocolate syrup. I got a pancake syrup. Just butter. Turn up. Put that shit out there. Now, mind you, at the time, me and my brother share a room. We in that room. Now, the room I'm in got four beds in the motherfucker. One bed over here. It's a room full of beds, basically. It's one dresser that holds TV and dress bags and bags for your clothes. Man, get your clothes bag away from my bed. Y'all ain't shit, man. So I gotta fuck up on my brother's bed because I got the bunk bed on the bottom. So that's not conducive to pounding pussy if you're on the bottom bunk. The top bunk too close to the ceiling for me to do that either. So. And really the top of where all my clothes at, because I'm a junkie nigga, so all of my shit up on top, you know what I'm saying? So I go fuck with my brother bed. Now mind you, it's just a mattress on top of a box spring, freestanding. Like if you wiggle that bitch wrong, that shit just tumble off that bitch, you know what I'm saying? We about, I'm trying to fuck and surf. That's the original surfboard. I'm not there trying to keep the bed on the other part of the bed and fuck. I ain't know what I was doing, stroke game horrible. This bitch got lotion and syrup on her. You know what I'm saying? I'm sticking to her. You know what I'm saying? This shit crazy. She don't know what to do, she just let me do it. I'm like, I'm fucking all day and do not bust a nut. I do not bust a nut because I don't know how to fuck. I don't know how to make it feel good. I don't even see the point. I've been jabbing at this pussy for hours. My dick is raw. I done popped a cherry in this motherfucker. Now I gotta wash and dry clothes for mama get on. All kind of shit. Yeah, so I'm trying to figure out what's going on, and I didn't realize what the problem was. But the problem was, like I said, I didn't know what I was doing. So guess what I got? It's my equipment to go get this first-time pussy. A condom that came out and took the hood by storm before we found out that condom wasn't shit. That black tuxedo lifestyle. When you had that black condom, the first condom with a color, you was like, yeah, it's how you kill them bitches right here. And you know what, nigga, ain't no pussy. They gave you a black balloon with some Vaseline on it and sold it to niggas. I'm up in there fucking with no feeling for these hours. So I'm fucking, and the condom obviously had to pop now that I look back on it. Because the pussy got tremendous out the blue, man. The pussy got so outstanding. Oh, 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 there's some swag in the pussy. Oh, hey, hey. Oh, what the? Now mind you, I don't jack off.
So
I don't know what busting a nut really feel like conscious. All my nuts have been unconscious on the way. You know what I'm saying? So this is my first conscious nut I'm about to buzz, and I don't know what it is. I'm like, I'm gonna throw up on this bitch, you know what I'm saying? OD, pull out. I swear it was like the hood Jesus or something was like, pull out, put you on. I pulled out, but I don't even know how much might have went in there. All I know is I pulled out and it was like an action scene, the movie where the nigga go crazy. It was like, oh, pour, 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 pour. What is it? Nut everywhere. It's a pool of nut on her. She got her elbows closed, trying to keep the nut from rolling in the bed and shit. I'm sitting there, my body just still. She like, give me some. I'm like, shut up.
This nut off that's now mixed with pancake syrup. I wiped it off, but I don't know. I think I must have bust three nuts. Well, I felt so light, like every all my steps was just, you know what I'm saying? Like things like running, jumping, touching shit, you know what I'm saying? Turned up, you know what I'm saying? Wiped it off, all that shit. But then I was like, damn, the condom bust. Cause then the condom was at the back of my dick, all tight, you know what I'm saying? Like I was trying to make a ponytail with my nuts and stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Not done
I'm like, damn, I hope she ain't gonna get pregnant. Man, I hope she ain't gonna get pregnant. Nah, I ain't, not your first time. Not your first time. You, God don't just, he ain't gonna do you like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, not only your first time, you should be straight. You know what I'm saying? I got a partner who believe in raw dog. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what you do. This nigga say shit like, hey man, pull that shit, yo, shit feel good. I can pull out that bitch. My homeboy DT, you know what I'm saying? I got my 350, yo. I done that bitch at work overtime. Fuck that shit. So I'm like, this nigga just, he ain't had a baby scared. And I know he the raw dog master. So I'm like, man, nah, I can't be. You know what I'm saying? Not knowing that I have had 17 years of potency swimming around my testicles. And when it jumped in there, boy, it was, I think it was like a real deal right in the ovaries. Like, all my ass, ain't no trying to swim in, motherfuckers got there. Pop, 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 pop. My daughter, the one that made it. I didn't know she was pregnant. She had a scare. She said she, her period ain't came on. We was talking. We broke up maybe like 3 weeks later. But her period was supposed to come on like 2 weeks. So it didn't come on. And she like, but it be doing that sometimes. Like, and, you know, she had one of the period problems. Like, shit be hurrying. Might last 11 days and don't come on. All that crazy shit. So I was like, yeah, cool. You know what? We end up arguing, breaking up the next week. I ain't fucking with it no more. But something said, just check and see what's up. Hey, you straight though, right? Yeah, I'm straight. Okay. Now I started hearing rumors at school that she pregnant. I called again, like, hey, I've been hearing you pregnant. You pregnant? Nah, I thought I was, but I ain't. You know what I'm saying? So, are you straight? Now, this 4 months later. She knows she pregnant at this time. I don't know she pregnant. Nigga, I keep hearing it. I'm like, man, y'all some haters. You know what I'm saying? I done started fucking all kinds of other pussy now living my life. Fuck around, I'll never forget the day. It was August 19th. The day my cousin was getting married, I got the freshest cut ever, ready to go fuck with the hoes on the other side of the family. Like, her husband family, you know what I'm saying? They from the islands, got all these island little cousins. Like, you ain't related. Hey, my kids cousins twice now, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, well, fuck around my cousin married family. I got the best haircut I ever got from South Carolina this day. I'm feeling so good. I'm taking a shower. I hear the phone ring. And usually I go run to the other end of the phone. You know you had the ID box. The ID box was on the 60-foot cord. And then the phone was on another 60-foot cord. So the ID box was way over there. I usually check it. You know what I'm saying? I'm a teenager. You know what I'm saying? My little bitches be calling. You know what I'm saying? You can check it. I ain't checking this day. You know what I'm saying? Family in town. Probably somebody needs some directions. Hello? Yeah, guys, we know me. Yeah, this him? You know who this is? Yeah, I know who this is. I don't know who the fuck this is, but I think it's one of my out-of-town aunties who I'm supposed to know, who I don't know, because they got a little accent or whatever. So I'm like, all right, just tell me what you need, so I can help. She's like, yeah, well, I just want to let you know that you're going to be a dad.
Damn.
Who you supposed to speak to? I don't know if you're going to be right by my daughter and the baby. But first of all, I don't know what you're talking about. Oh shit, the bitch praying for real. God damn. God damn, my heart beat. Oh, shit. Hello? Now, that was very disrespectful. And obviously, that just shows me how a mother raised her son. But I tell you what, you cannot want to do the right thing all you want to. We will go the other route to make sure you do for this baby and my daughter. Hung up on me. Hello, listen, I want to know if I can speak with her, you know what I'm saying?
could you put it on the phone?
Why the fuck you told me all this time you wasn't pregnant? Now you look, I don't want to hear none of that. It's here now. Now we can do. Oh well. What you gonna do? If you gonna do something, you ain't. Oh my God, my mama gonna kill me. My mama told me not to fuck with her. She told me not to fuck with her. Oh my God, she told me. God damn. I gotta tell my mama that these people saying that she pregnant. I go to the wedding with a heavy heart. I couldn't even make the hose. I come back from the wedding, and everybody enjoy that day. I wait till the next morning. I go to my mama's room in my night clothes, and I say, "Mom, remember how last summer Aiden came in there playing, talking about he had a baby on the wedding, and everybody laughed, but y'all find out he was serious before Trey got born." She's like, "Yeah."
I would die.
Boy, whatever. Like, I ain't had to say it. I was like, yeah, that's the one. It was Mary. The one you told me not to holler at. Yeah, she said she pregnant. She got one. She's like, okay. She took a call that day. She's like, well, we're going to see what's up. Don't worry about it. Ooh, I went to my room thinking it's good. She took a nap, woke up. I'm in the room playing the game. Like, yeah, my mom's going to turn up on these bitches. Blame her for trying to get what I got, which is shit. I don't got shit. I work at Winn-Dixie, so you know what I'm saying? My mama busted in there, boom, kicked the door open. I turn around, what the fuck? Get in here and do them dishes. I'm like, my week was last week. I did this all last week. So it's 8 week. You know what I'm saying? My brother's week. I'm like, 6 week. He like, yeah, I'm gonna get up and do them. Well, nah, don't do that to me, brother. Nah, you weren't doing that for him when he had his dash there. Use anything to bring up some shit they really mad about.
Right.
So my mama tell me don't go over there, don't be doing nothing until we find out what's going on. So they do the country shit. They wait till the baby get born and then they go over there and give the baby a look over. Cause all the babies in our family look away. You know what I'm saying? If you don't pass the look over, you ain't. Oh man, what if grandma say they ain't my baby? They ain't my goddamn baby. Grandma ain't here, but my auntie is grandma in training, so my mama took her sister with her over there. They went over there to give the baby the look over to see if this baby is a house. They come back from the look over, and I'm sitting there with pins and needles and shit, like, yeah, so what's up? My mama like, I don't see it. Walking in the room, closing up. I was like, my mama don't like to be wrong. That's all that is. My auntie gonna keep it real. Whether it hurt or not. Auntie, what's the deal? Well, my aunt said, I don't know. I was like, oh! Because if it wasn't, she was like, no, hell no. She like, I don't know. I mean, I can't tell. I was like, auntie, you just trying to save my feelings. Oh, okay, don't worry about it. So I'm not seeing the baby, my daughter 2 and 3 months, listen to my mommy advice. I work at the grocery store they go to, you know what I'm saying? So I'm stocking this shit. I got my other homeboy working. Every time they come to the grocery store, I run in the bag and shit. I'm just scared to see a responsibility that I don't think I'm ready for, because I can't take care of myself. I'm going to be next. You know what I'm saying? My mom can wash my clothes still. What the fuck? I'll take care of a baby. Man. They sit there, maternity paper down the house, we had to go get swabbed down. And the rule is, if the mama don't show up for the testing, and she got a certain time to be there, she get there a minute late, it's over, fuck it, paternity case out the window, all that shit. I know they don't got a car, I'm got my fingers crossed. So you don't have to look at the motherfucker, because people, what you looking at, fight right there. So they got a wall divide up. So I get in, I'm like, okay, I don't see him. I'm sitting, I'm stalking the door just to see him. The door and the clock, they both right there. The door clock. So I'm like, just tell him what time, you know what I'm saying? 10 o'clock, about to roll up, I'm like, oh. So 10 o'clock get here, but they ain't call my name yet. I'm like, I don't want no fucks, y'all want them to call me, and they not here, hurry up and call me. And they ain't pulled up, I'm looking at that door, they came out that door, State versus Harrison, that's what they do. The State versus United, that bitch don't win the guy. The people on me, you know what I'm saying? It ain't her versus the state. So, the state versus me.
Exactly.
I was like, yes, this bitch ain't here. I stood up. Like, I was ready to take on the responsibility for real. Like, hey, I'm ready to do what I gotta do. No, I wasn't ready to do shit. I went in there, started walking towards that room so I could sign this release paperwork. And who came from behind the wall? This bitch and her mama and the baby. Even know how to explain. You ever walked in a bathroom that was very clean and lift the lid up and it was a turd in there? That's how I jumped. I was like, oh, shh. And we in the room signing paperwork. I'm looking over here. I don't even want to look at the baby. The baby been crying the whole time. Even when I was sitting on the other side of the wall, the baby was crying. And I just didn't think it was my baby, but the baby cry was so fucking irritating. Like, it made the hair on my neck stand up. Just this baby, there's plenty of kids in there. This baby right here need to shut the... Who got the baby? I just drive me crazy the whole time. This baby screaming, just this one cry. It's up my... That shit is in my ear, like when you eat your ears ring. I'm looking this way, the baby's still crying over there. Go on, I'm talking about banana. Teasing and everything. Temperature sick, crying. I'm looking over here, I don't even want to look at it. I've been dodging this shit. Don't. And say hi to your dad. I'm like, shut the fuck up, bitch. But I turn around slow, baby crying his ass off, crying her ass off. And I look over at her, and she look at me, and she start crying. And we both looking, and I was like, that's my goddamn baby. I knew it right then. I'm talking about for a long time. She gave me the baby, we looking at each other. I'm like, oh my God. In my head, I'm like, oh my God. You tripping, bro. Here you go. Hey, man, ain't none of me. You know what I'm saying? We gonna see what's going on. You know what I'm saying? I'm scared of him, man. We did that test. I guess who gave him a ride home? The nigga praying that they didn't get a ride up there, you know what I'm saying? Cause I just got my little license, so I'm driving. I'm gotta drop this motherfucker off with the baby. I'm not looking back down, scared. My mama being nice and cordial. Everybody being nice because they both on that wheel seat. Like, yeah, so how y'all doing? Oh, we fine, we with all that shit. Drop them off. Take forever. It's my senior year of high school. I'm turned up. I ain't getting nothing back yet. Must not be nothing. I'm looking at this shit like an STD. I ain't heard nothing. So we take the test like January sometime. So I graduate in like May or June. I ain't get shit all these months. I'm turning up, going on trips, cutting school, got a car. I'm going crazy, balling out. One day, I'm talking about senior week at school, I get that envelope. Thick as a motherfucker. Like I applied to college or something, you know what I'm saying? I couldn't even open it. I walk around to my best friend career, Brian, and I'm like, bro, look, just open it and read it. Don't tell me what it say until I ask you. Just see what it say and then tell me when I ask you. But don't ask until I ask you. So he looked at it, closed and put it back in the envelope, I put it in my pocket. We walk, I didn't tell me. I pumped it like five times. Tell me. He's like, you sure? Nah, I'll tell him five times. I was like, fuck it, man. I gotta know. Go ahead, tell him. He's like, yeah, it's yours. I'm like, you fucking with me, man. You just trying to be funny. He's like, nah. I was like, for real? He's like, I read it, nigga, 99.9998. Oh, I'm like, what about that 0002 though? You know what I'm saying? Yep. And then I started doing what I had to do. Me and her became my best friend. Now she's a daddy's girl. And I love her. Hey, that's my story. At O.D. O'Dell is my best friend.